Today's review, Mikuro-chan Episode 1. Subscribe for seasonal anime episode discussions numerous times each week. If you're like me, you love horror movies, but have always been longing for anime that can stand toe-to-toe with the big dogs like The Thing, The Ring, or The Shining. Mikuro-chan is one of those few anime that appropriately creates a spooky atmosphere where you slow down and pay close attention just to get you with some grotesque ghost popping up out of nowhere. I don't know why it's called Mikuro-chan though, because its protagonist is Miko, a teenage girl who randomly gains the ability to see the dead who relentlessly haunt her. She pretends not to see them in hopes they go away, but they don't. I have to admit, I'm really cynical about pure horror anime because most of them aren't very good or they're just all gore. However, this actually gave me the chills for a bit due to how often they invade her personal space. It's like every time she turns around, there's some ghost waiting to pop up at her. They don't just pop up and leave either, they will stay there for like 20 minutes as she tries to remain composed and not lead on that she can see them. From episode 1, I think this might be an interesting anime to follow. What will happen next? Will the ghost try to talk to her, or maybe she will communicate with them? After all, they may look grotesque, but they do seem harmless. We also saw that they're able to interact with the physical world when they knocked her salt pile over, and the ghosts are likely responsible for removing her keychain from her bag, so if they had bad intentions, one of them would probably have made this clear by now. There's not much more I can add to my thoughts on episode 1 except for this one thing. Did you really think you could take this anime seriously? If so, this should adjust your expectations. Yeah, so this could probably be the next High School of the Dead or something, I don't know. I do know that most of my favorite horror flicks are halfway smut anyway, so I can't point the finger. I just see Mikuro-chan as a guilty pleasure series that you just watch for fun, but only time will tell. To retain my interest in this anime, they'll have to maintain its ominous atmosphere and increase the same level of suspense that they've already displayed. I decided to check this episode out because its manga got an 8 out of 10 on MAL, so I figured it's got some potential, but then again, horror generally works better as manga anyways, in my opinion. What are your thoughts on Mikuro-chan? Leave a like if you enjoyed the video and share with a friend who likes booze and boobs. Not the drink, but like, boo. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later today with Tesla Note Episode 1.